There's too many evictions, and we have a company that wants to build a giant luxury apartment building right across the street. And we're here also because the same man, Robert Rosania, that wants to build this building is from Park Merced, that has just laid off their longtime janitors and handymen who've been working with them. El mismo señor Robert Rosania, el dueño del negocio, que está también el dueño de Park Merced, que despidieron a todos sus trabajadores que han trabajado allá por años y años y se quedan ahora sin trabajo. So we gotta make sure they can hear us all around, okay? So tenemos que hacer un poco de ruido para que nos escuchen en todo el barrio. So we're gonna practice our chants, so we're gonna be marching later, okay? So when tenants' rights are under attack, what do we do?
Stand up, fight back.
When workers' rights are under attack, what do we do?
Stand up, fight back.
The mission is under attack. What do we do?
Stand up, fight back.
The workers are under attack. What do we do?
Stand up, fight back.
The tenants are under attack. What do we do?
Stand up, fight back.
And the mission is under attack. What do we do?
Stand up, fight back.
What do we do?
Stand up, fight back.
What do
we do? Stand up, fight back.
All right. Y'all sound good. All right. All right. Como son las trabajadoras de casa, las trabajadoras de negocios, los maestros y toda la comunidad, estamos recibiendo a cada momento ataques a nuestra comunidad, desplazamiento.
We were the ones that drove that, right?
So we're here today not only as community members, but as workers, right? Union workers, domestic workers, community-based workers. And we're here because every single day we're getting attacked. Our workers' rights are being attacked. We're being attacked by displacement, by eviction. We're getting fired. And that needs to stop.
What about
y hoy, San Francisco, todo San Francisco, exige solidaridad.
And today, as San Francisco, as all of San Francisco, we demand and we ask for solidarity.
Porque si esos trabajadores que ahorita están cómodamente en su casa creen que este sistema no los va a atacar, pues váyanlo pensando. Porque un ejemplo es San Francisco, donde ni los maestros, menos un trabajador de salario mínimo, puede vivir por los altos costos de la vivienda.
So for all the workers who are comfortably in their homes right now, thinking that this crisis will not touch them, the perfect example is this city, a city where teachers can't even live, let alone a minimum wage worker. So this crisis is coming for all of us, and that is why we need to stand together and support each other.
Woo! Yeah. Hoy estamos llamando a la solidaridad con los compañeros constructores del sindicato, pero queremos también que todo el sindicato se una al movimiento.
So today we're here in solidarity with our union brothers and sisters from SEIU, but we're also demanding that all the unions in the city be in solidarity with us, the community.
Porque como mencionando, y lo mencionamos bien, estos constructores, este sistema nos está atacando como un monstruo y no podemos caminar solitos. Tenemos que unirnos todas las organizaciones, chiquitas y grandes. Tenemos que estar juntos porque ayer, compañeros, acaban de darle 35 millones a la policía. Un cuerpo que no sirve para nada, que está atacando a nuestra comunidad. Y ayer teníamos que estar todos, pero no importa. Un error más, pero no debe haber más errores.
And that's why we need to walk together. We need to be in this fight together. Community and union, all the community-based organizations, big ones, small ones, the only way we will win is if we are united. Yesterday, the city approved to increase the police's budget $35 million. And that is a body that has done very little good for our neighborhood. And so yesterday we needed to be united, today we need to be united, and we need to keep walking this fight together if we are going to win.
Y eso es para toda mi comunidad. Debemos dejar de manipularnos por el sistema. Debemos dejar nuestro sillón. Debemos dejar un poco esas computadoras y participar con la comunidad. Necesitamos ser muchos en cada lugar que estemos porque los ataques están siendo fuertes. Y ayer solo 6 supervisores, un poco decentes, votaron en contra. Pero los demás que fueron votados por nosotros, votaron en contra de nosotros, porque tener policías no es la solución. Necesitamos lugares donde nuestros niños puedan aprender qué es justicia, compañeros.
Yeah. And so this is now a call for my own community to get out of our houses, to get into the streets, to get agitated, because that is the only way we're going to be able to win anything. Yesterday, only 6 supervisors voted against the increase in the police budget, and the other supervisors that were voted in by us, that we voted them in, voted against our interests. And so we need to keep fighting, and we need to do it together.
Por eso, hoy más que nunca, compañeros, necesitamos unidad, necesitamos solidaridad, necesitamos organización, y lo más importante, necesitamos reconocer que los poderosos somos nosotros.
So that's why today more than ever we need unity, we need solidarity, we need passion, we need action, because, and we need to remember more than anything that we are the powerful ones.
Y por eso los exhorto a que nos unamos. Ya dije, organizaciones, hay muchas en San Francisco, pero tenemos que estar unidos, compañeros. Es urgente que estemos unidos. Es urgente que trabajemos organizados. Es urgente que apoyemos en los lugares donde votan con gente que nos apoye, no con ratas como la de ayer.
Park Merced has always been a union friendly company. It's a new trend and a bad one. Park Merced is about to start a 30-year plan of demolition, construction, and the relocation of thousands of residents. Having known and trusted workers on site with us is vital for us. These displaced workers standing around me are They failed to workers and the residents and dependents. We tenants have always been able to count on these workers. They have been a valuable link in this chain of stability and continuity, as Park Merced, for many, many years. They are as much a part of our community as are our neighbors. Help us stop this now. Don't let these workers be the first of many such losses at Park Merced and elsewhere.
We know that our families and our neighborhoods, our communities are continually under attack by the impacts of displacement and gentrification. Landlords, speculators, and developers come into our neighborhoods and they displace people by raising the cost of rent, by buying and flipping properties, and building units that are unaffordable, making it hard for existing residents to stay in the city.
Entonces sabemos que nuestras familias y nuestros vecindarios, nuestras comunidades están bajo un ataque continuado por los efectos del desplazamiento y el aburguesamiento. Propietarios de vivienda, especuladores y desarrolladores continúan a desplazar a nuestra gente por el aumento de rentas, comprando y volteando edificios y construyendo nuevas unidades que son completamente inaccesibles para nuestra gente, haciendo que los residentes existentes de nuestra ciudad no se puedan quedar aquí.
So both Oakland and San Francisco are majority renter cities. And how is it that our elected officials can allow developers to come in to make deals and produce housing that is unaffordable for low-income folks, working class communities of color? How is that happening? It's not right, right? Do you all agree?
Yes.
Move to our elected officials who side with the developers. So we have the power. We have people power, and our elected officials should recognize that, right? And continue to work with us because we know what our communities want and what our communities need.
Oakland y San Francisco son ciudades donde la mayoría de la gente es inquilinos y nuestros oficiales elegidos están haciendo tratos y dejan que desarrolladores vengan a nuestras ciudades y vecindades y produzcan vivienda que es inaccesible para comunidades de bajos ingresos y comunidades trabajadoras. Y eso no está bien, ¿verdad?
No.
Porque nuestros elegidos oficiales tienen que trabajar para nosotros y tienen que reconocer la necesidad de la comunidad. Nosotros tenemos el poder y necesitamos trabajar para que ellos nos hagan caso a nosotros, para que ellos estén responsables a nosotros.
So we know that we live in a system that values wealth over human lives. A system that allows greedy landlords, speculators, developers, and investors to buy land for a profit.
Nosotros sabemos que vivimos en un sistema donde el dinero es más importante que la vida humana y un sistema que deja que propietarios de vivienda vengan y especuladores, inversionistas y que compren terreno para sus proyectos para hacer muchísimo más dinero. No tiene nada que ver con la necesidad de nuestra comunidad.
So we don't want development of luxury condos in our community. We don't want no monster in the mission. I'm part of a coalition in Oakland that's working. You may have heard there's a big project called the Coliseum Project where a developer will come in and build up stadiums, hotels, retail, high-tech offices, and thousands of units that aren't affordable to our people. And so it's great to see that tenants and workers are standing together. We need to stand in solidarity with the workers at Park Merced. It's not right that this guy Rosani can come in and just fire an entire staff of workers. It's not right.
Entonces yo trabajo con una coalición en Oakland, porque también allá estamos luchando en contra de desarrollos irresponsables. No sé si ustedes han oído del proyecto Coliseum City, donde van a construir estadios, van a construir oficinas de tecnología, van a construir hoteles, van a construir vivienda que es completamente inaccesible para la comunidad del este de Oakland. y también y allá, como aquí, estamos conectando las luchas de los trabajadores, las necesidades de los trabajadores, con las necesidades de los inquilinos de bajos ingresos en las comunidades en las que vivimos. Porque así es como vamos a poder ganar. Y tenemos que mantener solidaridad con los trabajadores en Park Merced, porque es completamente injusto que este señor, Robert Rosania, pueda despedir a todo un grupo de trabajadores por sus necesidades, porque él quiere hacer más dinero. Así que nos mantenemos unidos y hasta la victoria siempre.
So let's continue to build these kinds of relationships with unions, with workers, with residents, with faith leaders, with youth, with community members and community organizations to fight back against corporate developers that tend to push out existing residents and workers.
Entonces, ¿qué mantener estas coaliciones de trabajadores, de jóvenes, de inquilinos, de líderes de fe, para asegurar que podemos luchar en contra y ganar en contra de estos desarrolladores multinacionales que vienen y desalojan a nuestra gente? Unidos vamos a ganar. Gracias.
Thank you all and enjoy the day.
All right, thank you, Alma. Are y'all ready to march?
Yes.
So let me just say a little bit about Robert Rosania, because we're going to go. Okay. So let me just say a little bit about Robert Rosania, because we're going to go try and pay him a visit. So I don't know if you know Robert Rosania, the owner of Maxximus and Central Manager at Park Merced, but he is... you probably don't know him personally, but he is a connoisseur of fine champagne, and he is a very right-wing rich guy who donates to support politicians that are against everything we stand for in San Francisco. He's made contributions to support politicians who are against immigration reform, who are against gay marriage, who deny that climate change is even happening. So we cannot allow someone who is against everything we believe in here to come in and displace our workers and displace our communities in the mission.
Okay, entonces, solo quiero decirle un poco sobre el señor Robert Rosania, porque vamos a hacer una visita para verlo. Este señor está en contra de todo lo que apoyamos aquí en San Francisco. Él ha dado con su dinero a los políticos que están en contra de la reforma migratoria, que están en contra del derecho de la comunidad LGBT, y también que no piensan en el cambio de clima mundial. Entonces, eso es el tipo de señor que es, y no podemos dejarlo venir en nuestras comunidades, desplazar a los trabajadores y a nuestras comunidades en la misión también. Okay? So, thank you everyone for coming to so many community groups and unions here. I can't thank you all, but it's great to be here. Gracias a todos, ahí están, sindicatos aquí, gracias a todos a venir. And now we're ready to march. We're going to go up Mission Street on the sidewalk, and we're going to go visit Maxximus. And it's going to be really fun. So stick around, and everyone get ready, get in a line right here, and we're going to start our march two by two, okay? Are you ready? Ahora vamos a marchar, vamos a hacer una línea de dos en dos para visitar al Maxximus. Y vamos a divertirnos bien, creo. All right, are we ready? Listo?
A la lucha!
Stand up, fight back!
Hey, when tenants' rights are under attack, what do we do?
Stand up, fight back! no peace. You don't get no peace.
Greedy side! We can see your greeting signs.
You can't hide.
We can see your greeting signs.
Robert Rosania,
you can't hide.
We can see your greeting signs.
Robert Rosania, you can't hide.
We can see your greeting signs.
Robert Rosania, you can't hide.
We can see your greeting signs.
Robert Rosania, you can't hide.
We can see your greeting signs.
Thank you.
1,979 meses. We demand that the owning partners of 1979 Mrs. Maxximus Real Estate Partners and the Jang Family Trust, which I don't know if they're in it anymore. Either way, they're in here, and we demand of them too that they transfer the land to Community Half. Yeah. Exigimos que los socios, los dueños socios en 1979 Mrs. manden, hagan un trance de terreno a las manos de la comunidad. Queremos que ese terreno sea de nosotros.
And now, on behalf of the workers of Park Merced, where Maximus stepped in, where Rosani stepped in, and our workers are now on the street, out of a job, and those who are working there now are making minimum wage, we have... Los janitors y handymen de Park Merced que trabajaron en Park Merced, que le quitaron el trabajo, le pusieron en la calle, mientras que ahora los nuevos están trabajando de sábado domingo. Tenemos aquí firmado una petición firmada de más de 200 personas del Park Merced que visitan, que se regresen los trabajadores de sus puestos en el Park Merced ya ahora. Demanding that they put our workers back to work, as Park Merced, with preferred building services.
Boom! Boom!
We actually had another vote on the board.
Mexican who's running for his seat. We can actually make sure that when it comes to permitting that Maximus might try and get, that we have a lot of pushback to make sure that the community's voice is gonna matter and be heard.
That's right.
So there's
right.
a lot to do around that.
Yeah.
I was also a union organizer with SBIU back then, 1977. I was the rep for the workers at Park Merced. About 30-35 workers were there. They were maintenance workers, they were janitorial workers. They loved their jobs. Many of them had already, that was 15 years ago, many of them had already been there about 15 years. And it broke my heart to hear that the contractor under Maximus had actually delivered some real false information and worked to cut their jobs. And now they've been replaced by non-union workers.
Yes.
That was just spoken here right now. And the conditions are terrible. The union contract that we had in place was one of the best that was around. And the janitor at Park Merced fought very hard for it to happen, only to see Maximus and their contract and take it away. So I'm here also in solidarity with the workers. And to make sure that we do everything we can to protect them and build the kind of housing that we need for the future of San Francisco and the present of San Francisco as well. So thank you for being in this fight. I'm with you, and other part members of my Board of Supervisor colleagues are with you as well. And let's win. Let's win the kind of housing that we need.
Es nuestro deber luchar por nuestra libertad.
Es nuestro deber luchar por nuestra libertad.
Es nuestro deber ganarla.
Es nuestro deber ganarla.
Tenemos que amarnos y protegernos unos a los otros.
Tenemos que amarnos y protegernos unos a los otros.
No tenemos nada que perder más que las cadenas.
No tenemos nada que perder.
It is our duty to fight for our freedom.
It is our duty to fight for our freedom.
It is our duty to win.
It is our duty to win.
We must love each other and protect each other.
We must love each other and protect each other.
We have nothing to lose but our chains.
We have nothing to lose but our chains.
Es nuestro deber luchar por nuestra libertad.
Es nuestro deber luchar por nuestra libertad.
Es nuestro deber ganarla.
Es nuestro deber ganarla.
Tenemos que amarnos y protegernos unos a los otros.
Tenemos que amarnos y protegernos unos a los otros.
No tenemos nada que perder más que las cadenas.
No tenemos nada que perder más que las cadenas.
It is our duty to fight for our freedom.
It is our duty to fight for our freedom.
It is our duty to win.
It is our duty to win.
We must love each other and protect each other.
We must love each other and protect each other.
We have nothing to lose but our chains.
We have nothing to lose but our chains.
Nos despidamos todos con una tradición que ella nos va a enseñar.